Gang, what's up? So welcome back to the channel. Today is the 19th day of February, 2024. Again, I am back to teach you guys the best things you should know about forex trading. So in today's video, let me quickly take time to thank you guys for the new subscribers. I want to thank you guys for subscribing to my channel. I want to appreciate you guys for always liking the videos and giving me your reviews. You know, it's quite amazing that yes, there's been a journey all through this while. Nobody will understand how it has been, but only I. We understand that yes, it is not easy. Forex trading is simple, but it is not easy when you don't understand what you are doing in the market. But once you've understood what you are doing in the market, you can now then navigate. Let's say you can now then do whatever you want to do in the market, you know, trade whatever style of trading that best suits you. Forex trading is simple, but then you have to follow the rules concerning forex trading before you can say it is simple or before you can find it simple. Most of you are suffering in forex, but then it's just one thing. Once you attain that level of peace, calmness, peace of mind as a swing trader, you can just be chilling, you know, doing your own thing. Without you worrying about what is going on in the market and stuff like that. So, in today's video, I want us to talk about Fibonacci retracement tool. Basically, the Fibonacci retracement tool is a very, very important tool, technical tool in the forex market. You know, we traders, we basically use it as a confluence, and then let's say levels of taking our profits, we use them to know which directions the market are going to be headed at. So Fibonacci is basically, we have numbers consisting on Fibonacci, which are the negative 618, negative 27. We have the 618. We have the 50% retracement fee points, and then we have the 618 also. We are going to see all of this in the chart. So basically, we want to know how Fibonacci works. We want to be able to learn what Fibonacci helps us in. So let's jump into our chart so that we can be able to do this very, very profoundly. So this is Euro USD on the daily time frame. Euro USD on the daily time frame. So we're just going to learn about Fibonacci retracement tool and how it works. We are going to go to the past, and then we understand that yes, this is Fibonacci. So first, what you want to do is to mark out your key levels from the monthly time frame, like I taught you how to mark out your support and resistance. I taught you guys how to mark out your support and resistance. Very, very important. If you haven't watched the video, you can still go and watch the video, and then you know what you are doing in the forex market. You have to know how to plot these key levels. They are very, very important. Once you don't know how to plot them, Otilo, you are gone. You are gone. Don't know how to plot these levels, you are gone. You have to know what the market is actually doing at these levels. Once you are able to understand that yes, price is at a certain level, then you can navigate the forex market and know what you are doing. Exactly. I've plotted the level. So we want to basically learn what is Fibonacci in today's learning. So Fibonacci is basically where can you find Fibonacci on your trading view? If you go to your left corner of your Fibonacci of your trading view, you count from the first two you have there. You count from 1, 2, 3. Then the third one, you click on it, then you see Fib retracement. The first two you have there is a Fib retracement. Once you click on it, can then undraw it. These are my own Fib extension. These are my own Fib extension. So you can quickly can quickly screenshot it, and then when you are done watching the video, you can then set your own Fib extension. This one is 0, this one is 382, this one is 618, this one is 1, this one is negative 27, this one is negative 618, this one is 0.5, this one is 0.786. So all these things, I'm going to explain what they are on the chart so that we can be able to understand. Yes, my background, there's no background at all. If I put background, you see it's kind of displaying different colors, and that doesn't even look that looks awful for me. So I'm going to just remove the background. This one, I didn't check the box. I checked the box for price. I checked the box for levels, and then coming here, just these values here, the levels are to the right hand side, and then here the digits are on top. Font size is 14. You can also do your own font size. Trend lines, there's no trend lines. You can see if I put it, trend line appears, and then for that nothing appears. I removed it. So this is my own Fib. This is my own Fib settings. This is my own Fib settings. So where I'm going to explain what Fibonacci is. Fibonacci is a tool used by traders. Basically, in technical analysis, Fibonacci is a tool used by traders, basically in technical analysis. So the most reliable and important Fib extensions we are going to be focusing on are the 0.382 Fib extension, 0.5 Fib extension, 0.618 Fib extension. Then we have the 0.786 Fib extension, and then also this one here. So for this first one is actually when we have a market making higher highs and higher lows, higher highs and higher lows. Wait, let's just do this on the charts. Let's do this on the charts. That would be much more better so that we can understand what is actually Fib extension retracement too. So let's say that the market was going bullish. Let's say that the market was in a bullish market, and then reaching here, we are waiting for a trend to change. So the market has now changed trend and made the first lower high, made the second lower low, made the third lower high, made the second, made the other lower low, made the other lower high, made the other lower low. You are still waiting patiently. Then the market dropped drastically. This is where you now zoom out. This is where you now zoom out the market, and then you take your Fib extension point from the last high you had in the market. From the last high you had in the market, you draw your Fib to the last low you had in the market. From the last high you had in the market, you draw your Fib from the last high you had in the market to the last low you had in the market. Let me do it again. From the last high you had in the market, you draw it to the last low you had before that pullback started happening. This is on the daily time frame. The reason why I'm using the daily time frame is because the daily time frame is much more reliable for Fib extension. That is for the higher time frames. We do have the monthly time frame, the weekly time frame, and then the daily time frame. If you want to enter a trade, it is much more reliable on the daily and on the 4 hour time frame, because the daily is will I say close of business day, you understand? We get to see how traders reacted during the day. So that is why I am doing it on the daily. We're also going to be doing it on the 4 hour, but I don't want this video to be long, so we're just going to solely focus on the daily time frame. So on the daily, after drawing your Fibonacci from swing high, from the last swing high we had in the market, the last swing low we had in the market pulled back. It wasn't ready to drop until the market pulled back into this zone here. I always tell you guys about the golden zone. The market pulled back into the golden zone. Always wait for the market to pull back. Now, there are some scenarios whereby the market will move down, pull back into this Fib extension, and then continue dropping. In that case, you have to stay off the market. In that case, you have to stay off the market. If we reject from this point, this Fib extension here, what it stands for is for a longer trend movement. Whenever we have price reject from this Fib extension, yes, just be rest assured that we are going to drastically drop, because this is the first Fib extension where we always expect price to reject from. Then for this is the golden zone. I always talk about, it is always advisable to allow markets to tap into this zone. For some traders, they do not have this Fib extension. They don't have this one. They just have the 0.618 and then 0.5. They just have the 618 and 0.50 Fib retracement to extension, sorry. So whenever we have a drop, you drop from swing high to swing low, you wait for the market to pull into this zone. Then this is where you now go down to your 4 hour time frame. After going down to your 4 hour time frame, you get your entry. If you get a bearish close, let's say we have a bearish closure on the 4 hour time frame below this 0.5 0.5 Fib extension, this is where you now place your trade. Put your SL above here, put your SL above there, and then your first level target is obviously going to be the negative 27 Fib extension, and then your last take profit is just going to be at where price rejected, negative 618 Fib extension. And as you can see what the market did here, you can see what the market did there. Price got here to the last Fib extensions, the last take profit region, and then we got the rejection from these points. See how perfectly it rhymes. See how perfectly it aligns with this negative 618. This should be your first level target, and then this should be your last level target, obviously. So how the market came and then retested it and dropped down to this place. This should be your last level target. This should be your first level target. So that is it. You continue, you clean. After your target has been reached, this is where you now look for another swing high in the market. You now look for another swing high in the market. You are patiently waiting for price to give you that swing high in the market. This was the last swing high we had in the market. Enjoy your Fibonacci from swing high to swing low here. From swing high to swing low here. This was the last swing high we had in the market. This was the last swing low we had in the market. Enjoy it from swing high to swing low. and you can see the market tapped into the golden zone once more. The market tapped into the golden zone. Always wait for the market to tap into that golden zone. And if you go down to your lower time frame, you can see that the market also formed an inverse head and shoulder pattern here, very, very neatly inside the golden zone. The market formed an inverse head and shoulder pattern there, which we saw price drop drastically after that move. So this was our first level target, and then we later hit our last level target somewhere around there. This is how to trade using Fibonacci. Remember, it not always works out. You have to use it in confluence with the trend. You have to use it in confluence with the trend. If that is a trending market, yes, you can use it. But let's say we're having a ranging market, you cannot use Fibonacci at all. You cannot use Fibonacci at all on a ranging market. You can only use Fibonacci on a trending market, or on a trending market like uptrend or even downtrend. That is the only scenario where you can use Fibonacci retracement too. So let's continue. Market made higher high. The market made lower high, lower low. Then you took out your Fibonacci again, drew from swing high to the last swing low. You saw how the market is respecting the Fib points, pulled back, retested this golden zone we had in the market. Market retested the golden zone we had in the market. We tested it perfectly, and then our first level target was obviously here, and then came here and smashed our last level target. This is for a downtrend movement. Same thing is applicable to an uptrend movement. Same thing is applicable to an uptrend movement. You continue. This was the last high we had in the market. Take out your Fibonacci. You saw a pullback. Drop it at the last low we had in the market. You see that the market has rejected again from the 50%. The market has rejected from the golden zone. Your stop losses comes above the 618 Fib extension price. Then your final level target is the negative 618. You saw how the market is respecting these zones. You have seen how the market has been respecting these zones very, very neatly. Market came in and then rejected and continued making that higher high and then higher low. So this is for a downtrend. Then for an uptrend, we have the same scenario. For an uptrend, we do have the same scenario happening for an uptrend. Basically, the market must be a trending market. To use Fibonacci, the market must be a trending market. It must vary with a trend. If not, your Fibonacci is not going to work at all. Market must be a trending market. I repeat, market must be a trending market. So I'm just going to look for a bullish trending market. Let's use USD JPY. A bullish trending market. So nice, nice. So this is a bullish trending market for USD JPY. So what did I say? Must first of all identify the trend on the daily time frame, if it's bullish or if it's bearish. Must first of all identify the trend on the daily time frame, which is bullish or bearish. So for this case, we have it as a bullish market. So we had that impulse left to the upside, and then you have seen that the market is pulling back. This is where you now take out your Fibonacci. Place it at the last low you had in the market to the last high where you had price in the market. So for this brings me to what I want to discuss about the Fib extension points we have on the Fib levels. So what the market does here whenever we cross above or below here this is what we call a deep retracement. This is what we call a deep retracement. For here, whenever the market rejects here, this is what we call a shallow retracement. This is what we call a shallow retracement. So this is the perfect point for the market to turn from between 0.5% and then between 618 FIB extension point. That those are the two in between. These are the two perfect place for the market to really give you that confidence. So this was a pullback we had, a deep retracement pullback we had on the daily time frame on USD JPY. And once that happened, place your FIB from the last swing low we had in the market to the last swing high we had in the market. Obviously, you must understand that market structure is also in play. You cannot just pull out your Fibonacci and then you draw it from anywhere in the market. No, you must also know the trend of the market. Is it bearish? Is it bullish? You must also know market structure. For this, we had that market structure. Market was making higher highs, higher lows, higher. Market was making lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs. And then we came here completely and violated this whole structure. We came here completely and violated this whole structure. Market made a high and then made a higher low here, where we put out our Fibonacci from swing low here to the last high we saw in the market. And then the market made that deep retracement and we currently went to the upside. You saw what I was saying. This should be your first level target. You entered at a higher low. This should be your first level target. Saw how the market came in and then rejected, dropped, gave us that double bottom and went straight to this point. Market went straight to this point. And then we saw that rejection from that place, indicating that yes, this is time to take all your profit from the market, as the market does reject from that place. So this is very much explained. You must always identify the trend of the market. You must know when it is a nice pullback, understand your market structure, and then you know your entry signal when you get that confidence to enter the trade. So let's go. Let's continue. So obviously we're making that higher highs, higher lows, higher highs. So it reached a point again where we had to pull out our Fibonacci. This was the last low we saw in the market. Pulled out your Fibonacci, took it up to the last high we made in the market. The market came back, gave us that confluence on the golden zone. Once again, gave us that confluence on the golden zone, which is just like this. Gave us that confluence on the golden zone. Then watch what the market did after that. Just watch keenly what the market did after that. Guys, this is really, really very, very simple to grasp. Watch what the market did after that. Market rallied to our first level target, rejected small, and then went back to the last level target. You see how the market works? Very, 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 very sweet and very, very reliable that you understand how Fibonacci works. So this is all I have for this video. I guess you guys understand how the Fibonacci is being used. I guess you guys understand how the Fibonacci is being used. First, you must identify the trend of the market, the overall trend from the higher time frame, which is a monthly time frame. You scale down to your lower time frame, the daily time frame, to identify the intermediate trend within the overall trend. You trade according to the higher time frame, which is a monthly time frame. then you must know your market structure, you must know your entry signal, you must know where to place your own stop loss, and then your first level target, which is a negative 27, fifth extension, and then your last level target, which is a negative 618 fib extension. So thank you guys for staying with me to the end of this video. My name is Eddychuks. I'm a professional small forex trader, and I love you guys. Do the right thing. I'll keep on educating you guys. I'll keep on preaching it to you that forex is not a get rich scheme. It's to grow your capital to a reasonable amount. Forex is not a get rich scheme. It's to grow your capital to a reasonable account, and then you use it and find investors for yourself, just like I did. So guys, you're still blessed. Do the right thing and always follow your own analysis. I'm here to teach, I'm here to lecture you guys, I'm here to tell you guys this is not a get rich scheme. So do your best to do your best and do your best to win your best. Love you guys. Peace out.